When I was hired by my uncle in the publishing house, with the job of reading manuscripts and correcting page proofs, I felt like I had taken a step forward. I lived surrounded by books, breathing in the scent of printer's ink that to me was as intoxicating as a drug. I assumed the airs of a writer, with a notebook and pencil always in my pocket, ready when needed. I observed people, trying to read in each of them his individual story. And yet, I doubted that anyone would ever think of telling it to me someday. In any case, I had a permanent job in a publishing house, and, though it was poorly compensated, I held on tightly to it. And this was my first important out-of-town mission. My uncle had assigned me this task thanks to my command of the German language, though it has little similarity to the local parlance. Carl Gustav Jung had lived and died in Küsnacht, and that year, on the occasion of the 30th anniversary of his death, there was a three-day conference that involved experts from all over the world. To the speakers, famous in their circles, but to me completely unknown, I might perhaps come upon some text to publish, one not too pretentious, thereby inaugurating the new editorial series. Possibly, I wouldn't find anything of interest, and if that were the case, so be it. I would enjoy a brief vacation at the company's expense. I had not thought about booking a hotel, so I had to settle for staying at the Gasthof Adler, a clean, quiet inn, somewhat out of the way. An ideal place to write, I immediately thought. At that time, I assessed everything with the eye of an ambitious writer. The inn was a few kilometers from the town center, where the conference was being held in a municipal auditorium. There was a post bus that came by every hour, but even on foot, it wasn't a very long walk. And if you wanted to shorten it, you could take a path that cut through a dense, fir wood.